Today's American Story with Bob Dotson is a mystery. It begins down in Georgia, where a hiker found a city of lost graves. That discovery led to our newest national memorial breaking ground in Washington tomorrow, a place to remember more than 100,000 people all across the country who lie in unnamed graves.
This is a forest filled with forgotten lives. Their final resting place is marked with numbered stakes, not names. Overlooked until Bud Merritt stumbled upon them. He discovered the first of six lost graveyards at what was once the largest mental hospital in America, Milledgeville, Georgia.
These people were devalued all through their lives, so it's really no surprise they weren't afforded any dignity during their death.
Bud and his friends have found more bodies in those forgotten graves than the entire population of Milledgeville. At least 25,000. Across the nation, there are many more. About 100,000 who were hidden away in life and in death, lost even their names.
Why didn't families take bodies back home?
In many cases, families had exhausted every resource they had just to care for the person in life.
So, in death, they left it up to the Central State Hospital staff to bury their loved ones. Numbers were used instead of names to preserve patient confidentiality. But lists of the dead are incomplete. Some of the 167 years are missing.
I think it's really part of the irony is that there are documents in this museum that will tell you how many mules were bought in 1905. But when it comes to these thousands of human beings, it's almost impossible to find out where they were buried.
Casey McLean's family has been searching for her great-grandfather's grave nearly 90 years.
Groundskeeping had pulled up the stakes because it was too inconvenient to mow around the stakes.
Thousands were tossed aside. Bud set out to find them.
Each person buried out there has a story and had a life.
Casey's great-granddad, Herbert Williams, lost his wife, two kids, and his business all at once. Checked into Central State Hospital feeling depressed. Died of a broken heart. Heart disease 6 weeks later.
A dozen years ago, your family's story circled back to Milledgeville, and you went to work at the mental hospital.
Mm-hmm.
Did you have any reservations?
No.
But this was the place where you lost your great-grandfather.
And this would be the place where I found him.
Bud helped. He worked there too.
Central State at one time had 10,000 acres. That's a lot to walk, Johnny Appleseed.
Central State Hospital was a city.
With 13,000 people. But Bud figured the graves would not be on prime land.
If you could put a building on it or if you could raise a crop on it, it didn't have a cemetery on it.
That narrowed his search. 6 months later, Bud found Papa Williams.
Right under this dot is the exact location of your ancestor's grave.
Casey's great-granddad finally got a headstone.
He'll never be forgotten.
Because Papa never left her mind.
This is a battleground. And like the tomb of the unknown soldier in Arlington, there are hundreds of thousands of tombs of unknown men and women who didn't survive and didn't have a name, but now they do.
Because one man did not pass them by. For today, Bob Dotson, NBC News, with an American story in Milledgeville, Georgia.
You know, we have to be thankful that there are people in the world who grab onto something.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
And they
Absolutely.
Don't let go.
They make it their mission.
Exactly right, because a lot of us don't have that stick-to-itiveness, and it's mm-hmm. nice for that. Casey McLean, by the way, one of the lucky ones. Less than 1% of the people in those graves has been or have been identified.
Mm-hmm. Right. Hopefully there'll be more people who will try and find their past. We'll be back with more of today after just a couple of moments when we'll get to your local news.
This week, what works from creating an urban garden to reuniting soldiers with their families?